Well, hi everyone. It's Thursday. Welcome to Inspiration for Today. Are you ready to dig into God's Word together this morning? Well, we're coming to Ephesians chapter 2. Why'd I say Ephesians? It's Philippians. Philippians. Maybe Ephesians is someday in the future. I don't know. But right now, we're studying the book about joy and how to have a great life from Paul, who was in prison, not having a great life at that moment, but his attitude was so great. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever been in a situation where somebody made you feel very small and they were just so above you and in their mind, maybe they were economically or something else, but not really. Of course, you and I know not in God's eyes, because all people were created equal. It makes you feel so bad, doesn't it? But just the opposite. If you've ever been in a situation, maybe you can remember one, where somebody thought you so much of you, and they said, hey, come up here. You deserve this. I want to honor you. Don't you love that? And you so appreciate it? Wow. What a difference. Well, let me give you today's verse. It comes from Philippians chapter 2, verse 3, part of the paragraph we're going to read for today. He says, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but, and here's the key verse, in humility consider others better than yourselves. Let me just say it again. In humility, consider others better than yourselves. That's huge. It makes the other person feel so great. It makes you feel good that you're honoring someone else. Well, that's the challenge for today, and that's going to be the application verse for us today. But I want to put it in context of the paragraph that we're reading, because Paul actually is carrying on the theme kind of from yesterday. It was so important to him that everyone in the church, in the body of Christ, get along and be one in purpose, not having divisions. And we talked a little about that yesterday. Well, in the start of this paragraph, Paul gives us four conditional statements. And you know what a conditional statement is. If. Well, I have to ask you, as we read these four conditional statements, do any of these apply to you? I think they all apply to you, probably. Verse 1, chapter 2. If you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any fellowship with the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, I believe that those of you whom I know, you have all those. I hope, you know, those who, I wish I knew everybody, but those I don't, I'll bet these are true of you also. If you are a follower of Christ, it's hard not to. Because he says, if you have any encouragement with being united with Christ, it's always encouraging. Christ gives us purpose and reason and encouragement in life. So we have that. If any comfort from his love. Oh, I don't know anything more comforting than the love of Christ in my life and in your life. If any fellowship with the Spirit. And we've talked recently about how believers, all believers, have the Holy Spirit. So certainly we have fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And if any tenderness and compassion, and those things are things that God gives us. And he gives us sometimes through his people, other people. Well, if you have any, then, this is like an if-then statement. And here's the then, verse 2. Then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and purpose. In other words, again, have a close-knit unit with your body of believers that you are a part of. Doesn't have to be Saddleback, Laguna Woods. It can be whatever church you're attending, but have it. Being like-minded in the same love, spirit, and purpose. And then our verse for today. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility, consider others better than yourselves. If we do that in our fellowship of our church, then wow, of course we're going to be one. That type of attitude is so amazing. That's why I got to tell you, we joke around about various ministries in our church, and many of them are kind of behind the scenes. In the old days, in Clubhouse 5, we said this was often of those who put out the seat cushions so that we could be comfortable while we worship. With the current chairs that we have, we don't need seat cushions anymore, and that's a good thing, I guess. But there's a lot of other ministries that are just behind the scenes, such as bulletin stuffers. You ever thank the bulletin stuffers? Probably not, because you don't know who they are. It's done when you get to church. Or the coffee makers. That's a hard ministry, actually. But the guys who do that, it's putting others first. It's humility. It's humility. I love that they do that. Verse 4, each of you then should look not to your own interests, but also the interests of others. And that, of course, is kind of like the golden rule. Do unto others as you would have them do to you. And I'm just impressed with those who serve in humility and do these things. It's so awesome. But to belong to a church and then to help that church, that's the fellowship of those who share in the Holy Spirit. It's phenomenal, and it's awesome. We're in this together. Don't you love Rick's statement he often uses? We're better together. We are. We're better as a group than we would be as just individuals. It's awesome. I love the way that the Lord put together his church. I got to ask, so are you a member of your church? I hope that you are, because I think, I used to, in fact, I started a church back east where we didn't even have membership. We have been parts of churches that have no, in other ways, no membership. But now, as I've gotten, I think, more into the word, I totally believe. Rick often says a Christian without a church is like an orphan. I just know that I am blessed by being a part of Saddleback and the way that we uphold one another and the things that we can do for one another. Our Class 101, which is our membership class, will next be held on Saturday morning, February 5th. And I would encourage you to be a part of that. Sign up, call the number, call the church office, sign up. Give it a try. At the very least, you'll find out what your church believes, as well as the history of Saddleback Church. And both of those are good things. But if the Lord lays it on your heart, you'll have the opportunity to actually become a member, joining officially into the family. And I hope you'll consider that prayerfully. Do you pray about that? But just attend the class. It's a fun class. I give you breakfast anyway. So it's a good thing all around. Give prayerfully thought to that. And then we're going to, today, let's you and I try to treat others with humility, putting them above us. God bless. Have a great day walking close to the Lord. I'm going to see you tomorrow with a very important passage.